Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 486 in high definition.
A site for work, now a place of tragedy after a man is killed on the job today. Good evening. Glad you're here. I'm Michael Cogill.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. Sky 4 is live tonight over the scene in Greenville County.
This happened on Scuffletown Road in Fountain Inn, near the intersection with Jones Mill Road. News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski was there this afternoon and joins us now. Gabby, what are officials saying about this tonight?
Well, Michael, tonight Greenville County's Chief Deputy Coroner calls this an extremely unfortunate accident. From the air, you can see emergency vehicles and rescue equipment. On the ground, workers sat still, heads hung low, after learning one of their own was killed.
They were digging for a water line. It's my understanding that a piece of equipment in the ditch rolled over onto my deceased.
Greenville County Chief Deputy Coroner Mike Ellis says 28-year-old Pedro Alberto Miguel Perez of Greenville was pronounced dead at the scene, and another man was injured and taken to Greenville Memorial.
He was partially pinned with the piece of equipment and had to be extricated.
Ellis says there were multiple workers in the 16-foot deep ditch at the time of the accident. He says they were using an auger-type piece of equipment to dig a hole to replace the water line.
It is being treated as an extremely unfortunate accident.
And we're told the men were working for Payne, McGinn, and Cummins, Inc. General Contractors, which is based out of Travelers Rest. Coroner Mike Ellis says an autopsy will be performed on Perez tomorrow. Now, the man who was injured, Sam Schudel, is in serious condition tonight at Greenville Memorial. Michael.
Gabby, thank you for that. Greenville County deputies tonight say a church piano player and teacher had sex with one of his teenage students. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local in our digital studio on this story tonight. Mike, this case is not closed, right?
That's right, Michael. Deputies say they don't know if there are any other victims. As for the suspect in this case, he no longer works at the church, but he is still connected to it.
Any of us is prone to fall.
Pastor Ronnie Powell says the proof is in his church, New Life Baptist.
We let our guard down 1 minute. Satan's going to get in, our enemy.
Powell says relatives of a teenage girl came to him about 6 weeks ago and told him the girl had sex with a church employee.
I'm called to preach the gospel, not do police work. And this is a job for police.
Family went to Greenville County deputies. Powell says he went directly to the accused, Roman Harkins, and asked for his resignation. Harkins played the piano with the church ministry. According to a warrant, Harkins was giving the girl, who was 13 at the time, a piano lesson at the church back in January of 2011, and when they were alone, they had sex.
New Life Baptist Church is a great church. Soul winning church, and we have lots of people saved here, and Satan don't like it.
Harkins was 23 at the time. He's 25 now. Deputies arrested him on Wednesday and charged him with criminal sexual conduct with a minor, second degree.
Satan's alive and well, and he's trying to do everything he can to attack and tear down the church.
This is a church where Harkins' dad is the music minister and his mom plays the other piano. Pastor Powell says they will continue to work here as long as the allegations against their son don't interfere with their mission at the church.
As Christians, we're in a battle each and every day, and we just got to be aware that we are in warfare. Every day that we get up, it's a spiritual battle.
And we were unable to reach Roman Harkins for comment. Deputies say anyone with information about other possible victims should call 23 Crime. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in the digital studio.
Mike, thank you. A decision tonight in the Joey Preston political corruption case in Anderson County. The state grand jury has ended the investigation and finds Preston not guilty of any crimes. News 4's Keisha Foster joins us live and local in Anderson with more on this. Keisha, this was a lengthy investigation, wasn't it?
Yes, Carol. For 2 years, the grand jury investigated any possible wrongdoing in the Preston contract buyout of 2008. And after interviewing numerous people and reviewing 10,000 documents, the case is closed.
In black and white, a final decision was made on a case that had Joy Preston seen red out of frustration. The report reads in part, the grand jury has thoroughly investigated all of the activities and events associated with the buyout severance agreement of the former county administrator and other related relevant matters concerning other members and or employees of Anderson County. Preston released a statement to WYFF News 4. He said Anderson County Council put him and his family through an endless amount of distress. Quote, I'm glad that the citizens who served our state's grand jury have seen through these smear tactics and rendered a fair decision on the lack of merit of these claims, end quote.
The outcome is, it's what it is.
Anderson County Sheriff John Skipper hopes the community can heal and move on now that a decision has been made. An investigator from his staff assisted a SLED agent in interviewing some of the 18 people who testified before the grand jury.
The process is what it is. You know, we have had now an impartial body look at whatever was presented, and as a result of that, these impartial body has reviewed it and they've made a ruling.
And News 4 contacted Interim County Administrator Rusty Burns, who speaks on behalf of County Council, to comment on this outcome, and our call was not returned. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in Anderson.
Keisha, thank you. A federal court has appointed a receiver to sift through the assets of a former Anderson County Council member accused of running a Ponzi scheme. The court appointed Betty B. Ashmore yesterday. She will take control of Ron Wilson's assets and find a fair way to distribute them. Wilson was charged in April with mail fraud after authorities say he took millions of dollars from investors. The investments were through Atlantic Bullion and Coin. But the investors never got the silver bullion that was promised. Court records show Wilson told investigators he bought silver and shipped it off to customers in 25 states. But he told employees and customers that the silver was kept in a depository in Delaware.
Deputies tonight tell us a possible thief was caught on camera, and they're asking for your help to help find this person. Here's a look at this picture. They want to take you a long look at this thing. Anderson County deputies believe this person victimized a car restoration shop on Singer Road. And we're told this has been going on for the past 2 years. In the latest incidents, we're told about $8,000 worth of items were stolen, including tools, auto parts, and a forklift. If you know this person, can help find him, call Crime Stoppers toll-free, 1-888-CRIME-SC. And check out this site as well. This is surveillance video from the Dirty Dog Car Wash on Reedville Road in Spartanburg County. All this happened on the evening of June 5th. Police say the man you see there in the video is eventually going to break into the change machine and steal money out of there. If you know this man, you can help find him as well. Call Crime Stoppers again, that number, 1-888-CRIME-SC.
Asheville police say a woman reported missing by friends turned up in Savannah, Georgia. Friends say they last saw Yvonne Goodwin on June 4th. They say she left them for an appointment with the cable company representative, but no one had seen her since. Police say she was found in Savannah at a Quality Inn early this morning.
We certainly know this is a nightmare that can turn real in a hurry. The scenario is horrific. A gunman opening fire inside a school full of kids.
It's all too real a threat, and law enforcement is training to deal with it. News 4's Kim Quintero tonight with an inside look at officers bracing for the unthinkable.
April 16, 2007, a day marked on the campus of Virginia Tech as the deadliest shooting massacre by a lone gunman in U.S. history.
When you have these mass shootings that have plagued this country, by the time a SWAT team can gear up and get there, it's done.
Don't move! Don't move in!
Which is why law enforcement agencies across the country, like here in Newberry County, are putting first responding officers through elaborate training exercises designed to simulate the worst.
Don't move! I'll shoot you!
Inside Newberry Elementary School Thursday morning, sheriff's deputies and city police encountered a shooter. During the simulation, the group moved through a hallway. The suspect shot his hostage and led them to a stairwell. Gunfire erupted.
Every lifelike scenario includes these bullets. The shooter gives off a red wax coloring, law enforcement a blue. The idea is to account for where every bullet fell and who shot who.
In the end, the suspect was shot. This time, no officers were wounded. A Hollywood-like drama aimed at teaching these officers real-life lessons.
Those decisions that you make could save lives or it could cost lives.
Newberry County holds this training every year for their officers, firefighters, EMS, and the school district. University is expanding into North Charleston. A new center will be built at Clemson's Restoration Institute at the old Charleston Naval Base. It will be called the Zucker Family Graduate Education Center. The announcement was made this morning. The center will be a place where students, faculty, and businesses can work on taking research developed at the institution and using it in the marketplace.
And it will be about job creation, and it will be the place where corporations around wind energy and around restoration and around power systems will work together with Clemson faculty and scientists, and they'll work side by side with scientists from these companies. And part of that whole experience will be we'll have third graders witnessing this. So when they go back to study math, they're going to know why they're studying it. And we think that's a powerful idea, and we think it can help transform the Lowcountry.
The institution is currently building a massive facility to test wind turbines.
A Greenville community center that almost had to shut its doors a couple of years ago is bustling with activity again. In fact, check it out here. Dozens of children are at the Phyllis Wheatley Center this week for the start of summer camp. Last year, this camp was not available. You may recall the center ran into financial trouble in 2010, had to cut back on programs and operations. And since then, the center has formed partnerships with a local charter high school and a church to help keep the programs running at full capacity.
It takes people in the community, volunteers, people coming over and wanting to be a part of something.
Center's board chairman says if they can make these community partnerships long-term, they'll never have to suspend operations again. They do plan to have after-school programs again this fall for the first time since that financial scare.
Get ready for some action on the diamond. Tonight, News 4 will be in Omaha to cover the Gamecocks. It's part of our College World Series coverage. To kick off our local coverage, make sure you tune in for our 30-minute special, The Road to Omaha. It airs tonight at 7:30, right here live on WYFF 4. The show will also air on this TV, WYFF 4.2.
Now, your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
Right now, things are fairly quiet outside of the mountains, just partly cloudy skies to mostly sunny skies, no precipitation. But as you can see, take a look at live Super Doppler 4HD. There are still scattered showers and a few heavy thunderstorms, especially in the southern and central mountains, especially the southern mountains of North Carolina. And some of these thunderstorms, very little movement with the thunderstorms. But I want to go ahead and go back to this morning where you probably had an early wake-up call. Look at these thunderstorms. I talked about it verbally last night at this time that some of the computer models were hinting at this backdoor front coming in and possibly having enough energy to produce thunderstorms early in the morning. This is at 6 o'clock in the morning. They actually started even earlier than that. Right over Greenville, Clemson, Anderson. Then these thunderstorms just slid off into northeastern Georgia as we went through the morning hours. Very heavy rain, and these thunderstorms were locally severe. In fact, we'll go ahead and look at some of the storm reports as these thunderstorms continued to make their way off, developing over Greenville and then sliding off to the southwest. All right, some of the reports in Pelzer, some wind damage from those thunderstorms. This was early this morning at Hardwood Road and Palmetto Road. Also, we had reports of hail in Williamston from those thunderstorms. Also, some wind damage being reported around the Honeypath area in Anderson County. We're also talking about the same thunderstorms producing wind damage in the city of Anderson itself, with along with dime-sized hail being reported. And then we also had in Anderson some more wind damage in certain areas. So this is the cluster of thunderstorms through Anderson County, then all the way into Hart County. Almost 1-inch diameter hail being reported in downtown Anderson. And also there it is again. And also in Hartwell in the town, multiple trees down across Watt Sadler Campground. And this was in Hart County in and around Hartwell. So incredible thunderstorms early this morning. Then they just weakened, and then that front pushed through. The humidity levels came down as expected, and temperatures warmed up nicely. 82 was the official high today. That's still about 4 or 5 degrees below the average for this time of the year. 68 to low this morning. Just a trace of rain reported at the GSP International Airport. Much more in the downtown airport in Greenville this morning, though. 79 was the high at the Asheville Regional Airport today. 61 the low, and no precipitation reported during the day today. Very warm outside, as you can see, outside of the mountains. Cool spot, 66 degrees in Boone. It's 75 right now in Hendersonville, 73 degrees in Franklin with that heavy thunderstorm just off to your west. An east to northeasterly breeze continuing to bring in lower humidity levels. Only 46% right now in Rutherfordton, 47% in Greenville, and also in Spartanburg. Temperature-wise, 84 in Florence, 84 right now in Columbia, 86 in Augusta. Only 78 in Greensboro, 75 in Raleigh. So here comes the relief from the heat and high humidity as we go through the next several days. There's the scattered showers. It's actually the surface low that has developed out here in southern Alabama. That's producing these thunderstorms in western Georgia, southern Georgia, down into southeastern part of Alabama. And then we're looking at those scattered showers and thunderstorms in the southern mountains, in particular of the mountains. So For tomorrow, some cloudiness to start with in the upstate. An east to northeasterly breeze will pick up speed in the afternoon. Partly sunny skies, beautiful day, high temperature 83 degrees, humidity levels not extremely high. Areas of valley fog tomorrow morning in the mountains, a light east to southeasterly breeze, partly sunny, high 77 tomorrow. It should be dry across the entire area for the weekend, looking pretty good. Mostly sunny to partly sunny skies, highs in the low 80s in the upstate, mid to upper 70s for the mountains. Good looking upcoming weekend.